I did something that I haven't done in a long time, but I followed a tutorial. Hi there, welcome back to my channel Scrap and Coffee. Today I'm going to show you a project that I've made, but it was designed by Paul Ford and I followed his tutorial, and his tutorial is called The Memory Box with Wallets. And he has amazing tutorials on his channel. And he has a project chair for this project with the Mechanical Sea by Stamperia. And then he has the tutorial with the Amazonia paper pad from Stamperia. And they are amazing projects. So definitely go check it out because this is a project that you want to make for yourself. I've used the Vagabond collection from Stamperia as well. And I love how this turned out. And the fact that Paul Ford is showing you in his tutorials how he decorated totally helps me in using all these enormously large images in the collection. So if that's something that you struggle with as well, I would say definitely go watch that. So I had the Sir Vagabond 12x12 paper collection and I only had a few sheets of the Lady Vagabond collection. And I also had the wooden shapes from the Lady Vagabond collection, but I've only used the Lady Vagabond in the wooden shape. So this is the wooden shape here and one here on the flap of the box. And this I cut out of the, I believe it's the front sheet where all the die cuts are on the back, that I fuzzy cut it out. So the box, I just love how that box comes together and I've used the technique that Paul is using with the book binding tape and I really enjoyed making the box that way. So that was a lot of fun and I'm really, really happy with the result of this box. So this is a magnetized flap here and we can open that up. And I didn't really decorate the inside. Maybe I will go back and do it, but for now I don't feel like it needs it. I did decorate here the flaps because I wanted to hide the magnets, of course. So I'm going to put the box to the side and show you what is in here. So first we have the V-shaped wallet that can hold full-size photos on both sides, so it's closed in the middle so your photo doesn't fall, and I really like that about this design. Really useful, and you can add more than one in each pocket, so love how that turned out. Then I have the side opening wallets, so we've made two of those because you put them together next to each other in the box, so they are in my box like this. A lot of my images are actually in this orientation because that's just what the images of the paper collection scream to me, like use me in this way, so that's what I did. And I changed this design up just a little bit, not because I wanted to, because I really liked what Paul did, but I just needed a few extra inches for my image in this paper. So when I open this up, and this flap is what I've added, in the original design you only have this flap which opens up down, and then you can place your photo of whatever it is that you want to keep in here. And I really like that, but I just needed that few extra inches. So I have that when I open it up, and then this one technically opens up to the bottom, but of course you don't have to do it that way, but for the image. And then we have this. So this is the complete image. I only had to cut off a little bit on the sides, but that's okay. And then of course this can go down as well. And I will probably use it sideways anyways when I actually handle it, right? But I just love how that looks. And I can close this up again pretty quick and easy. So I'm just going to put it to the side for now. Then I have the large wallet. Which again, in Paul's design it's like this. I've made it like this because of the image. And I fuzzy cut around the cat here. And the cat was actually on this side of the paper, but I just cut it off and placed it on the flap. And I've backed that with cardstock in order to make it a little bit stronger and make it a little bit pop off the page a little bit more. So I can open this one up, and then we have the rest of the image of the Lady Vagabond there. And again, this is a large deep pocket and you can place a lot of stuff in there, so you can do photos or you can do some other stuff that you want to keep safe from whatever it is that you are trying to keep, right? Photos or folders or something. Then I have the sliding wallet, so I can open it again like this, and then Sir Vagabonds appears here in his complete shape, and we can slide this out on both sides for a full-size photo on one side and a 4x4 on the other side with pattern paper. So really fun one as well. And I love how easy these things come together. And you can also just, I've been working on this in the evenings, and you can just start on one of these and just finish it completely, and you feel like you have something finished when you have a lot more to do, of course, but it really is, the word is not coming to mind right now, but it's satisfying. That's what I was trying to say. Then I have the little flip book here, and again, I've made the image where when I open the flap you have a more complete image, but from this one I had to cut down quite a lot, but I've used the back side of this for the outside of the box. And you can flip this for full-size photos. You could do full-size photos on both sides, but I did full-size and 4x4, and then some pattern paper there. Just used some scraps that I had left over. So again, this comes together really simple, but it's really effective with a lot of photo opportunity in here. And we close that again. And then I have another V-shaped wallet, this time in this direction. And again, I can place a full-size photo in both pockets. But I changed it up a little bit on this one because I did two. So here we really have that V-shape. And here I just come in a little bit straight and then made the V-shape. I was just playing around with it a little bit. It's quite hard to get your pattern paper cut exactly right in this way. So maybe you just want to keep it to this one, which looks amazing, right? And then what I did is I made a large version of the flip book. So this is the actual design, and I've made a large version that has the same dimensions as the larger inserts for this memory box. Because I had a really large image of Lady Vagabond that I wanted to keep complete. So again, I can open this and then I have that complete image on there. And then I've made this for full size photos. On this side, I stamped them in the portrait style because this is how you can use it, but you can also use it in the landscape orientation. So that's totally up to the user and how you want to do that. And I just love how this turned out. So I did one flip less in the larger one. This one has one more flip in it. And then finally, we have the stacked pockets, angled stacked pockets. So again, these papers nicely fit together. And you can place a full-size photo in these pockets. And I don't know why it doesn't want to go in now, but full-size photo, and you could also do that here, but I would probably do a full-size in the back and then a smaller one in the front. So really love this one as well. And then I have in my box, I have everything lying here, make sure that it doesn't fall, some cutter parts from the collection that I definitely want to give a place. I can place them in one of the pockets. You can journal or put a photo on the back. Some really fun cut apart. So I just have them in the box for now, but I probably will use them in the wallets or inserts later on. So we can fit all of this back in here. And it's just, I'm so in love with this project. It turns out amazing. So please go check out the tutorials because you will love this. No, that one is going in last. Of course, I have a certain way of putting this in there. And this one isn't closed yet, but there we go. And then this one, and then this one. And you see there are no photo mats in my wallets yet, but I still have more than an inch here on space that I can really bulk this up. So no problems there. Close it, and you have this really nice memory box to keepsake some nice memories and photos. So if you are interested in making the album, please check out the description box down below and find Paul's YouTube channel because you are going to love making this project. For now, I want to say thank you for watching and enjoy the rest of your day. Bye bye.